Hey folks, welcome back to the Portable Gamer, welcome back to F1 2017, and welcome back to Shanghai, China? Yeah, this is China. So, I'm still trying to sort out how to do the replay on these, but we'll get started and I'll tell you what's going on. Here we go. So the crazy thing is, I qualified on the pole. So that's me, well, that was me out front. In the Williams, getting banged around. So I believe Vettel is in front of me now. Or Raikkonen, one of the Ferraris. And then Bottas, I believe, gets out in front of me. So, yeah, I guess I'll do the replay of the whole race. I don't know. And you can, as always, you can skip ahead to whatever part you want. You skip ahead to the end. But I did the practice programs, and they went really, really well, like a lot better than they did in Australia. So I was super pleased about that and got some good points for research. And then we went into qualifying, and I just, like, I was first all three rounds. Now, you can adjust the AI. I've got the AI on 40 right now, and you can adjust the AI mid-season, so I guess I need to bump it up a little bit. Or, I mean, maybe I don't, because I don't win. I get on the pole, but I don't win. And you can see I'm still, you know, it ain't perfect. Got a ways to go yet. But I was pleased that I was on the pole. And I feel like, you know, the weird thing about that is it's not really racing, you know? It's because you're on the track by yourself. And the way that I set it up, like, I just, as soon as the session is open, I run out and get a couple laps in. I don't do well in quali when there's anybody else on the track, but I was first all three qualifying. And I did screw up a little bit because for some reason I was still thinking like conserving tires. So they put me out on they wanted to send me out on these are the Ultra Soft. Yeah, Red's Ultra Soft. So for Q3, my engineer wanted me to go on Ultra Soft, and I picked a set of scrubs, and I didn't make the connection that it's Q3. We're racing these. So what I should have done is gone with new Reds, new Ultra Soft, and is it Super Soft? No, Super Soft, not Ultra Soft. Red is Super Soft. I should have gone with new Reds, new Super Soft, and just put one lap on them and had those to race on. And instead, I went with Super Softs that already had a couple laps on them from Q2. And I won't make that mistake again, but it was just like wonky that for some reason I was still thinking we needed to save tires. So qualified on the pole, and then you saw I took I didn't take any damage, but I got knocked around a little bit, and I'm in P3 right now. Let me see. Camera is this. Nope. That's camera is this. There we go. So yeah, I'm in P3, and it's this replay is weird because there's no real information. Like I don't know what lap it is. I can't hear my engineer, but yeah, I'm super pleased with this, and it's weird. This track is so different, at least for me. This track is so different than Australia because I felt like I go wide a few times. I get a little hot a few times, but I felt like the AI was just pushing the pace so much more in Australia, and I always had to be kind of like outside, not my comfort zone, but I was going faster than the car wanted to go. Here, the car feels really planted, and I feel like I've got a little bit more to give. I don't feel like I'm like absolutely on the edge of, you know, the car spinning out of control at every second. And that's the way I felt in Australia. So we do, we settle in here, and it was so reassuring. They were forecasting me, or they were wanting me to finish eighth, my agent, and to be in third and just kind of settling into a groove. And we'll go back to TV coverage. To settle into a groove and you know, there's cars behind me, but I'm not like freaking out. And that's something that's always kind of tripped me out about AI, is taking damage, getting bumped. I have to say the AI in this sim is just tip top. I think it could be the best racing AI that I've ever like raced against. It's really, really good. It seems like it's always doing, I think that's me getting a little frisky there. I think this is, yeah, DRS is available now, and I think I'm getting a little grippy on Bottas. But yeah, it was so nice to settle in. Starting to get cloudy, and it is going to rain. So my engineer tells me, because we started on the super soft, and I think it was like lap 4, lap 5, my engineer is like, okay, pit in now. And I realized by then that I had started on scrubs, but it still seemed a little bit early to be pitting, particularly with rain coming. So I want to say, we'll see. Because this is, honestly, I was so gripped this whole race to be in third and to not be hitting things. The whole, every lap, I'm like, don't hit anything, don't hit anything, don't hit anything. Like, I'm thinking even if I just lose a spot every now and then, I can still finish eighth, which is what they're forecasting me to finish in. And to be in the Williams early in the season when we really haven't done anything on the R&D tree, to be in third in the Williams is like, I was just like, if I'm dreaming, don't wake me up. Everybody just be cool. So it eventually, the tires do start to get a little bit ragged, and I do pit, but I keep getting ahead of myself. But let's just watch together and see what happens. I know I didn't record in car, and oh, look at that. I believe I just made a green flag pass on a works Mercedes, of all things. And then I pit, which is, you know, it's what you call your strategy. I'm so gripped. I've gotten so many stop-and-go penalties in just doing single GPs, not season, but practicing this race as a single Grand Prix. I get constantly dinged for pit speed violations, so I'm going really, really slow. Okay, so they got me on the soft now, and it's like, I'd say it's about lap 5. So they got me on the soft, and I come out in, let's see, P20. So I guess I'm the first to pit. And you see this sky? Like, my engineer is telling me to pit, and it's like, I don't think that's a good idea. I don't know that we want to pit right now, because I know it's going to rain. So I have the softs, and I feel like the rest of the field is on super soft, but they're on new super soft. So if it didn't rain right now, this would be a solid, maybe even a one-stop strategy, although I can't see. It was a 28-lap race. I don't know, 23 laps on soft China, maybe. But it was like every 2 laps, my engineer is all, we've got a new strategy for you. Do you want to give it a try? And I can't look down and read it because I'm not crashing. And that's my big thing, is like, when I'm not smashing into things, I'm just so happy to not be smashing into things that I really don't want to look away from the screen, even to try to read a little pit menu thing. So let me see, you want to do this? Yeah, let's do this. So I know I'm going to have to come in for intermediates, but what happens is when it does start raining, and I believe it starts raining here fairly quickly. When it starts raining, now my engineer is telling me, you got to stay out. It wouldn't be worth it to come in for intermediates yet. You got to stay out. And it's like, dude, seriously? Are you just messing with me now? So what I would have preferred was to stay on the super soft scrubs for another couple laps, right? So stay on those scrubs a couple laps longer than I should have, and then maybe come in for intermediates like a lap before I should have. But we end up, almost everybody ends up staying out after it's like well and truly raining. And it's not raining yet. I don't know if we're going to get rain on the visor in replay, which is the best way for me to tell whether or not it's actually raining. I imagine we will, but if not, we'll be able to see it on the track. So I get the line pretty good, and I've done this race. I've done two or three like practice GPs, just standalone GPs. Two or three of these at Shanghai in the past week, because I really wanted to get this race. You know, we finished, what, 17 out of 20 in Australia, and everybody, 18, 19, and 20 were DNFs, and it was like, ah, that's not very, you know, it's not a very good showing. Not my proudest moment, so let's do something a little bit more spectacular in China. And also, frankly, we got to work our way up in the points, so, and I'm passing, who is that, Alonso, I think? Yeah. Gotta be Alonso. Who else blocks for like 17th position? So I was super pleased with the way this turned out. And then the funny thing was, like, one of the standalone GPs that I did, it did rain. It rained the whole, like, torrential rain. We were on wets. We weren't even on inters. We were on wets the whole race, start to finish. So I've got 28 laps of this track on wets, and I feel like that really helped out, man. This turn one, I don't know, whatever you call this thing, this like kooky in out decreasing radius, hairpin increasing radius, I don't know who thought this was a good idea. It's, in a way, it is a magnificent turn complex, and at the same time it's just ridiculous. So I feel like, I mean, right now I'm loving this strategy. I started on the scrub super soft accidentally, but to be on these softs and just working up, and I believe, man, I need stats on screen. In the future, that's what I was saying a minute ago. In the future, what I will do is, there's a YouTuber that I watch, and if you follow F1 2017 on YouTube, I'm sure you know who it is. He does career mode, and he did like 6 or 7 years of career in a row, so like 7 seasons of career, and he's amazing. But what he does is he records the race, I guess, in car, and then he records the replay, and then he cuts the two together, and it's just spectacular. It's so good. The thing about it is, that's his thing, you know, and I don't want to, like, no copying. I don't want to copy. So I'm really kind of conflicted, like, how I can do this, because the best way to have race information is to record in car, because that's where the stats are, and I don't think you can get stats on replay. So there's no way to get, I'll check when I'm done here, but as far as I know, there's no way to get a HUD during replay. So it's just me, like, describing what happened, and that's kind of hokey. So I don't necessarily want to do what he does, but I can't see another way to have a HUD and lap information up there. And it looks like still no rain, but it's getting super cloudy. So great strategy as of right now, and I feel like it may have held. Somebody's locking it up down there. I think that, well, initially it was the McLaren locking up, and then it was me locking up. So to be on soft while everybody else is on super soft, and to be working my way back through the pack before other cars have pitted is fantastic. And then a bunch of cars do pit, and I end up in like P7 or P8. And then the rain, things get a little wonky. Yeah, you can see I'm still, it's not pretty yet. It's not elegant and flowing. There's a lot of almost kind of sawing on the gamepad. I really hate that look. I do my best to be like super smooth and steady and not, you know, tap at it. But it's still, I feel like I'm kind of ragged sometimes. And that's something I'm working on all race sims. And even in the trucking sims. I do a lot of American Truck and Euro Truck. And even in those as well, I want to be just super, super smooth. Is it raining yet? Not yet. So then the other thing that happens, and I don't know if we'll be able to see this, man, I'm going to have to record in car because we also get the engineer's voice. And you can see, like, and I wouldn't mind seeing it on replay either, but down in the corner, down in the lower left, I wouldn't mind seeing some of the messages that are flashing up as far as new pitch strategy, what mix we're in, because I am switching back and forth between, I started about one lap heavy on fuel because I anticipated running Rich a lot and kind of cheating with Rich. And I know it's supposed to be kind of a push to pass thing and not something that you would want to run for like laps and laps at a time, but I anticipated needing more Rich than I did. I actually did most of the race in standard, but what's interesting is the Rich that I did use, we finished with about, okay. All right, so just wide there, but no damage. We finished with about half a lap of fuel. So I started one lap heavy, and I didn't think I used Rich a whole lot, but maybe I did. So basically what happens, and it's going to be, let me bring this back, we're about 20% of the way done. What happens is we're right at the end of, I don't know what you'd call this right here, this sort of secondary, because there's really three straights in this track. But right before the front straight, safety car comes out, and I think, so here's safety car here. Is it raining yet? We'll see. This is kind of going to be a surprise to me too, because I can't remember now how this all worked out. And I think part of the problem is because I did those practice GPs, and all of those had their little drama and what have you. So now I'm trying to catch up to safety car, I think. And this is showing me in P4, so I believe when the safety car came out, everybody pitted. So this is going to be me behind, like, looks like two Ferraris. So it's got to be Raikkonen, Vettel, and I believe Bottas. I think early in the race, I got a message from my engineer that Hamilton was slowing down. So let's say we're behind. Let's say we're behind Raikkonen, Vettel, and Bottas. Okay, cool. Man, I don't know. I'm just happy I haven't hit anything yet. And it sounds kind of crazy to say that. I don't know how you sim race, but for me, it's like, oh, here we go. So the car is wet, but I'm not seeing any rain on the visor, which is kind of a shame, because if you know this sim, you know how much the rain just kills your visibility. I'm going to scroll through all the views. Oh, no, there's a little rain. Okay. Yep, there's some rain. Okay, cool. So maybe it does show up on the visor. I don't need to scroll through anything. Don't hit Bottas. So now this is when I start battling with my engineer, and he's like, don't come in. And I've got the voice command, so I keep pressing, you know, push to talk, and I'm like, set intermediate. Box this lap. And he's telling me, don't go to intermediates yet. Stay out on slicks. And we just start skating everywhere. So, all right. Cool. And let me see. I'm curious when Vettel, Raikkonen, and Bottas pit. But either way, I'm so pleased with the way this race went. And I'll go to the very end. Because there are some developments, some things happen here. But feel free to skip ahead to the end. Skip ahead to the last 2 or 3 minutes if you don't feel like sitting through all this. You're not going to hurt my feelings at all. And I don't know if Nope, lights are still on. I'm going to mute and cough. I'll be right back. Right. I will turn the AI up incrementally. So I think I'll bump it up like 5 points for the next race. And just, well, oh, that's tricky though, because I don't know. See, I've never done a full season on F1 2017, so I don't know if I just got lucky on this track. So then I crank it up, and where's next week? Is that Bahrain? It's Bahrain, and I'm going to have some upgrades too. I think we're getting ready to race. Yeah, bunching up. I think next week is Bahrain. And I'll have some upgrades. You know what? Let me leave the AI the same. I wasn't planning on doing well in points per season. So let me leave the AI where it is. And then we'll just play it by ear. Because I haven't won a race yet. So it's hard to say that the AI is, you know, too mellow when I haven't even won a race. But I'm totally pleased that I got this, and I came into this accidentally. I was trying to get F1 into a Assetto Corsa. It didn't work out, and I got frustrated and wanted an F1 sim. And there's a couple, but really there's only one, and it's this one. So we got the rain. Oh yeah, we got the rain. Okay, cool. So we'll stay in car for a while. And I think, even in the rain, I think I managed to keep up with these gangsters fairly well. Fairly well. And then eventually, I want to say when my engineer springs me to come in for inters, that it's when they come in as well. Because I feel like I go in. I feel like I pit in fourth. I pit P4 and I come out P4. Or like, they pit and the following. So I'm P1. They pit. I go to P1. The following lap, I pit and come out P4. But yeah, it's just, my engineer just keeps telling me, stay out, stay out. Which is, I have to say, that's a nice feature. And then the being able to talk, to just say things is nice, like being able to ask for intervals and being able to ask, you know, how far ahead is the car in front of me, how far ahead is first, you know, that sort of thing. And like, where did he go? There he is. Hey buddy. Yeah, still needs a little practice, still needs a little work, but definitely an improvement over Australia, and that I'm super happy about that, because I was disappointed with Australia. I had done that race, same as I did with this one. I had done a couple GPs to practice, and I thought that I would. They were telling me 12th. My agent was telling me 12th was where they were forecasting me to finish, and I would have been happy with 12th. And it's one of those things like, oh, you know, 17th is only 5 behind 12. It's not like 12 is a points position or anything, but it's still just, it wasn't cool. So I feel like I've kind of redeemed myself. And it sounds like I'm teasing out the ending, like how well I finish. All right, still got a little ways to go. And I think, yeah, I feel like this even has the deal where it's raining on one part of the track and it's not raining on another part of the track, which is also super awesome. And compared to where Sims were a few years ago, that's so advanced, because it used to be... I was talking about this in Spirit of Le Mans DLC on Project Cars, the video that I just posted, where it used to be that if it was raining, it was raining, and it was like the code dropped your traction accordingly, and that was it. And now these tracks have like tire temperature and standing water and degrees of rain. Is it raining a lot? Is it raining a little? Is it raining on the whole track? Is it only raining on part of it? Like, if it's just raining on one corner of the track, you don't want to pit for inters, you know? And that's just such an amazing, realistic detail. This turn kind of kicks my ass, too. All this decreasing radius stuff messes with me. Although I do start to get it by the end. Yeah, it's barely raining here, but then there's other places where it looks like it's coming down pretty good. Yeah, we're just skating all over the place. I want you to be able to hear... Man, I'm on the fence about this. I don't want to just do what that other cat does. Because he's amazing. And that's his thing. Alright, so this is me pitting for inters. See how early I slow down. But it looks like a lot of people come in behind me, which I hadn't really seen before. Okay, and there's at least one Ferrari, and it looks like Bottas out in front. So, well, both Ferraris wouldn't have come in on the same lap. So one Ferrari, one works Mercedes, and I believe I go in. Well, it's easy enough to see. So it looks like P5? P6. Okay, so I pitted P4, came out P6, but I'm on inters now, and I stay on these tires till the end of the race. I don't... I feel like I don't... As crazy as this sounds, like, I don't need them for the whole track yet. There are places where it's still fairly dry, but then it rains really hard, and then the track starts drying. So it's like, we did need them, but we didn't, and then later we do need them, but we don't, and then we definitely need either these or wets, and then again at the end, it's like, is it worth it to pit for Ultra Soft for 5 laps? You know, are you going to be able to make up enough time on a drying track? It's not even a dry track, it's a drying track. Are you going to be able to find enough dry... Are you going to be able to find enough of the dry line to make use of Ultra Soft, and are you really going to make up that much time in, you know, 5 or 6 laps if you pit after it stops raining? So much strategy in this game, and I love that. And it's also, there's strategy during the race, but then you have strategy for the whole season as well, and I love that with the engine allowances, the engine allotments, and tires, and, you know, Q1, Q2, Q3, and Park Ferme and all of it. It's plus the R&D trait. So I'm as impressed with this game. I'm as impressed with the strategy as I am with the actual, like, driving the car in a race part of it, which is awesome. But the strategy is super cool too. So how are we doing? About halfway. So I think, So I can do one of two things. I can pause the recording right now, fast forward, pick it up again, and then splice the two together, edit the two together. You know what? Let's do that, because I feel like you stuck around this long, and I don't want to torture you. So next time we come across the start-finish, I'm going to pause the recording, fast forward, and then I'll just do the last couple laps. Trying to visualize where we are on the track. Okay, cool. Hey. Alright, so this is... Okay, I know where we are. I think I do. Yeah, I know where we are. Okay. Even on inters, I'm still fighting it. And this is Vettel, I want to say. Not Vettel, Verstappen. Okay. Good for me. Maybe we will let this roll a little bit. I had forgotten all about this. So we are in... So we're P4, so a couple more people did pit. We're back to P4. It's definitely raining now. And we got Verstappen making a move. Interesting. Did you get it? Yep. Yeah, so that's what that YouTuber does, is he cuts together like all the interesting bits, and then he essentially does commentary over it. I would never try to do that. I mean, I might cut together the highlights, but I would never try to call a race. I mean, and he calls it like a soccer announcer. Just really getting into it and yelling, super excited and really animated. It's amazing. If you Google F1 2017 career mode, you'll find him. And he's something else, man. So maybe I'll do highlights and then just talk over it like I'm talking right now and not actually call the race. So what that means is I will record in car. And then I'll cut them together. Okay. Cool. Wow, there's a lot going on behind me. The way I have my field of view set up, I really can't see a whole lot in my mirrors. I just go on the proximity arrows, which are also not showing right now. But I can see the proximity arrows, but I have no idea, like, all this tomfoolery is going on right behind me. Man, what an amazing time it is to be alive as far as sim gaming. I'm so, like, Spirit of Le Mans on Project Cars 2, I am so, so geeked about that. It's... To be able to drive the old Le Mans course, and I talk about all this in that video that I just posted. To be able to drive the old Le Mans course in an old 917 is amazing. And it's not, you know, compared to where Sims were 10 years ago, and it's like a whole different animal. It's amazing. And then to go from that and hop right in here, hop right into... 2017 Williams. What is this? The FW40? Yeah. And race, you know, in the rain, progressive conditions, you know, it's... Wow, they're like jackhammering outside my hotel room. I don't know if you can hear that. I'm hoping that doesn't continue. So, to be able to play this level of simulation gaming and to know even better, like to know there's going to be even more cool stuff in F1 2018 when it comes out in 2 months, you know, when it comes out in August. I don't think I'm going to be able to get the season done because we're going to have F1 Friday is going to be the thing on the channel. So we're going to have one F1 race every Friday. Now what I can do is if I have, like, I'll do two races during the week. So this week is, what, Bahrain, and then Canada comes after? I don't have a calendar right in front of me. But let's say it's Bahrain and Canada. So I'll record Bahrain and Canada, and whichever one comes out better, that's the one that I'll post. But then the week after, in real time, will be like 2 weeks ahead, or two events ahead in the schedule, because they don't do one every week. So basically what we'll do then is we'll do 20 events in 10 episodes. Or, yeah, that's the other thing we could do, is we could combine two races into one episode. But that would definitely have to be highlights, because if we're going to go 30 or 40 minutes. Yeah, okay. So that's something to think about too. But yeah, man, just not just on off rain, or not just it's raining during the race, but that it can start dry and can go to wet. I've seen where it's raining and qualifying and dry for the race, dry for qualifying and then raining when the race starts. So it's all in the there's a weather forecast, which I think is fairly accurate, but it's not 100%. And I feel like if it's calling for rain, it's like you have to set the car up with extra ground force, extra downforce. You have to set the car up basically for rain, even if it's not raining during Q3. Does that make sense? Or you'll be kind of useless when it starts raining before the race. I think I said that right. You know what I mean. But like, just the level of detail that is required to plan and run an F1 team in real life, obviously not that same level of intensity or accuracy, but you know what I'm saying. Like, you got to plan the whole weekend, and then you need to figure out how the weekend fits into the whole season. Just super awesome. Super awesome. I'm so pleased with this. All right, we're making tracks. It looks like we're about two-thirds done, so. Tricky. Tricky through that turn one complex. I don't even know what you call that, because it's... technically, it's like six turns, but technically, it's like one turn, because it doesn't really begin or end until you're all the way out of that decreasing radius sweeper thing to the left. It's a lot more fun to do a sim race when I feel like I'm not struggling for 30 or 40 minutes, when I feel like the car is not getting ready to eject itself from the track every second of the race. I do feel like, even for the Williams, I feel like the car was kind of planted, and I feel like that doesn't really have anything to do with the AI. That's strictly how I set the car up, and I got the setup from, I just went to a search engine and typed in F1 2017 track specific setups, and I found a whole mess of them. And it's like, for every car there are four setups. There is, for every car, for every track, so if you go to China as an example, if you go to China and you find Williams, it'll have China wet wheel, China dry wheel, China wet gamepad, China dry gamepad. And I set up for China dry gamepad. We're actually running a dry setup here, but this is, we're on inters, we're not on wets. But it's pretty wet, but it's not like monsoon. One of the practice GPs that I did, we were on blues the entire race. We were on full wets the entire race. Started and ended on blues. So it was wet. And for that, I went with the wet setup. But right now, I'm content with my dry setup and inters. And I'm trying to look on my Motec. Yeah, there's no... all we've got is an interval to the position ahead, I assume that is. Or is that, that might be top corner. I've got plus 3.454. I thought it was an interval, but it's not changing, so I suspected it might be delta between this, delta between the previous lap and our best lap. We'll see. No. Could be sector, because it just changed. Well, whatever. It's an interval of some kind, but I don't see... it's not showing what lap we're on. No, it is telling me to pit. And I feel like... huh. I was so focused on the track, I have to say, I really didn't even see that during the last part of the race. But to be fair, I could see my position in the HUD. Now there's a guy, there's a sim racer. I race all cockpit. I don't use TCAM. I race all cockpit. You'll see that when we do Bahrain next week. But I do use the HUD. This cat, this like accuracy cat, does not use a HUD. He strictly uses cockpit cam and just the info panel, the MoTeC. And having seen that, I guess I ought to do that too. The only thing that kind of trips me out about that is mix. Now, your engineer will tell you where to go with mix. So, like, if you run rich too long, he'll tell you you're about to go out of your positive fuel balance or whatever. He'll tell you to go to standard. And in one of those races, one of those practice GPs, he told me to go to lean. So it's like you don't necessarily need to see that. And I believe, like, when the engineer comes on the radio and says, we're considering a new strategy, do you want to keep the new one, or do you want to keep the old one, or go with the new one? I believe it pops that up even if you have the HUD turned off. So, okay, so that's something to think about. But I would consider going cockpit view, no HUD for the replay. No, that doesn't work. That defeats the whole purpose. I was just talking earlier about how, like, we have no idea what's going on right now because we have no HUD. So if that's the case, then even if I wanted to turn it off for immersion, it might make sense to leave it on for... Hang on. What's that say? Oh, it still says pit. From this view, I thought it said P something, like P4, but it says pit. So, okay, so that's a trade-off then. If we turn it on so we can cut back and forth and know what's going on with the car, like, with regards to the race, then we lose a little bit of immersion. But you think it's worth it? Interesting. So... did that Ferrari... Okay, well, he had to have pitted in before me, and then he came out in front of me. So, I'm guessing that's... yeah, because I want to say it was Raikkonen, Vettel, and Bottas on the podium. So, the Ferrari... well... at least one of the Ferraris was far enough in front of me that they could pit and still come out in front of me. Okay, cool. We're almost done. And I won't make you sit through another one this long next time. I'm just kind of getting a feeling for how we want to set these up. But I think I'll do what that guy does. I think I'll record in car and then cut it together with a replay. No, hopefully that'll make it a lot shorter. Rain effect, I don't know. My settings are all cranked pretty high. But I still feel like the rain effect is not... it's good, but it's a little blocky. It's not great, I have to say. Not complaining. There's really nothing to complain about. This is an amazing sim. And I think... we're lap, like, 22, 23 right now. And I want to say my engineer is telling me we're about 16 seconds off first. Which is not terrible. And it's not insurmountable. But we don't get there. I feel like on old inters, on a drying track, I don't know that I'm going to be pushing hard enough to make up. Well, if it's four laps and we're 16 seconds down, I'll be trying to make up 4 seconds per lap on the leaders. Not likely. most likely outcome from something like that would be me just stuffing the car, like I almost did right there. I'm also, it's really weird, when I get behind traffic, like when I get right behind traffic, I get so gripped, I just get useless. I feel like right now my skill level only allows passing like with DRS and rich mix on a straight, or maybe a little bit of late braking. I think we did a couple late braking passes earlier in this video, but honestly, they were both on like, it was for like 20th and 19th and 18th. We were not, I feel like I'm not going to make some aggressive late braking green flag move on Kimi Raikkonen. You know, I'll try it on one of the Haas or something, but not on a Ferrari or a works Mercedes. Yep. Gotta be near to done by now. Oh, I just saw we're rocking the 13. That's so cool. You get to pick your own helmet, you get to pick your own race number. And it's one of those things where this game has so much detail. I don't know how long we've been watching this replay. 45 minutes. And that's just the first time that I noticed the car has my number and I'm wearing my helmet. Now you can do a custom helmet, but I haven't done it yet. Got to go into the game code and put your custom helmet graphic in there. I've seen a template floating around. So maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll do a custom template. Right on, man. And I didn't smash the car up. I know that sounds like kind of a no-brainer, but I went wide so many times in Australia. I think I told you I pitted like 5 times, and I had a stop and go, and then I had 3 5-second speeding penalties. So it was, Australia was a catastrophe. We kind of fast-forwarded through that, but I feel like this was more representative of, I'm not the best sim racer in the world, but I'm not terrible. So I feel like this was definitely a better representation of what I'm capable of. I think we may be P5. Because what are we coming up on here? Toro Rosso? Is it Toro Rosso? Yep. I think maybe I do get a pass on him, but I don't know if it's for position. Or if we're lapping him. I think it's for position. I can't remember. Yeah, it's the amount of room that I need to comfortably make a pass. Part of it is being on gamepad and feeling like I don't have that absolute sort of finite control of the car. I wiggle a little bit, I saw a little bit, but also just getting more comfortable with being that close to traffic, and with open wheel cars being so fragile, you know, just touch something and the engineer is on the radio like, you got light damage to your wing, don't make it worse and you should be okay. And it's like, well, you know, I didn't want to make it bad in the first place, and now I have less downforce on the front, right? Like, I was understeering before, that's why I hit that guy, and now I have less downforce, so I'm going to understeer more. So to not hit anything for the entire race, for me, is like, that's a banner day. All right, we're just about done here. So I've got two. You start with some points, and then you, I didn't really get any points for Australia. I did the practice programs. I got a few points. Oh, I did a lot better on the practice programs in China as well, which I was super pleased about. So we're going to get some points for our finish, and we've got two upgrades that are already in place that we'll get for Bahrain. And then I did some... This is my strategy. We've got two minor upgrades that we used 1,000 points a piece for. But then I did a lot of... Because I'm going to stay with Williams for my entire career. I've decided I'm not going to switch. So I'm going to commit to continuing to improve this car. And to that end, I started with a lot of improvements to testing and reliability, which means that we won't have as many parts failures. So if you know the game, if you follow the game, you on your R&D tree, you spend points to improve various parts of the car. Reliability, chassis, engine, and downforce, or aerodynamics. So you can spend like 1,000 resource points to improve something, and depending on how big it is, or how whether it's major or minor, it will take a few races for it to become available. To right, like back at the factory, they're doing the research, and then in a few weeks it'll be ready for you. But your engineer, or your GM, or whoever, Chris, will tell you from time to time, even though you spent the points, it failed quality control and it didn't work, and we don't have that part now, and you have to spend another 500 to finish it, right? Like to make it deliverable. So what I did is I spent on one part of the tree, I spent 500 resource points so that that will happen percentage wise, that will happen less. It's not that it won't happen at all, but I invested the points to make it happen less. And then I also invested some points so that all my research would be cheaper. And that's one of those things where technically it doesn't do anything, but I feel like it's going to pay dividends later, because that will be that many fewer points that we'll have to spend to develop the car, and that many fewer times that a part will fail QC, and we'll have to spend not just another 500 resource points to finish it, but we'll have to wait another race for it to be ready. So I'm trying to play the long game with the Williams. And I went with Williams. I'm a Mercedes guy, but instead of going factory, instead of going with the works team, I went with the Mercedes engine Williams, because I didn't want to pick like one of the top cars on the grid, which would be Scuderia or the works Mercedes, or even Red Bull. I guess they're pretty strong, so I went with Williams, and I'm gonna stay with this team for my entire career, and I'm gonna build the car. Now, the other thing that's weird about R&D is watching that guy that played like 7 seasons in a row. Yeah, I think we're done here. Watching him, like when he... Because you get offers to switch from one team to another depending on how well you do. Other teams will make you an offer. And watching that guy, when he went to another team, he started with Renault, I believe, first season. And he raced with them like one or two seasons. So say season 2, season 3, he switched to another team. When he got to that other team, the AI had been doing R&D as well, different than the R&D that he had been doing with Renault. So the AI teams continue to improve their cars. It's not like, so I'm in the Williams right now. It's not like I make improvements to the Williams and I just gradually build a dominant car. The other teams are improving their cars as well. So if you do switch teams, it's like you don't have to start over on R&D. You sort of take over the R&D that they've already started. So it's an amazing level of detail. I'm hoping that F1 2018 is better. I know for the most part, that's the way it works out. You know, as games patch up and as new versions come out, they tend to be better. But not always 100% guaranteed. Is there one more lap? I guess there's one more lap. Which is how you end up with, there will be a game that's kind of out of cycle. So it's 2017 right now. This is F1 2017. You hear people say, oh, you know, F1 2012 was the best F1 game ever. And it's like, well, how could it be? It's not totally state of the art. It's not totally totally contemporary. It's not the newest and best. How could it be that good? But there are games that just find that perfect balance, and they're really, really good, even if they're not 100% new. So I'm hoping that F1 2018 continues the trend and is better than F1 2017. Because I've pretty much already committed to buying it. I haven't seen it for pre-order or anything, but I'll get it the minute it comes out. And I'd like to finish a season between now and then. So let's say I have June and July, so call it 8 weeks. So it would be 18 races in 8 weeks, and I'm going to post one per week. So, like I said, maybe I'll double them up, or maybe I'll do... I know Bahrain is next, and I want to say Canada is the next one after that. I'll do Bahrain and Canada next. I'll either edit them together into one video, or I'll pick the better of the two, do a video of that, and just tell you what happened in the other. Like, you know, I finished here, I got these many points, and this is what I did for R&D, or whatever. Figure something out. I believe this is our finish. And then we'll cut to T-Cam. I never go T-Cam. There's in-car. Yep, TV camera. So from here, I'll cut to the screen that shows where we finished and where we are in the points, and I'll call it. And it looks like we're at 56 minutes right now, so it looks like we'll be about 1 hour, and I'll try not to do too many more episodes this long. I know these get is that it? Yeah, that's got to be it. Okay, so now we want to exit. Go here. Right, so we finished fourth. And if we... Where's my controller? So if we go... No, do not restart the session. So if we advance, let's see where we're at for points. Maybe. Is it going to give it? Loading. Now, I've heard some of these screens, if you show them, you'll like run afoul of FOM. So if it cuts to anything like showing the F1 logo, I might need to blur that out. Wow, that's a long load. Okay. Clean lap. Right. Continue. I need to know... Alright, I'm leading my rivalry. I need to know where we are for points. Ooh. Oh no, these aren't resource points. This is just my score. Okay. So, let's look in the laptop and see, does it show us points? Leaderboard, R&D, power unit. No, it's not going to show it. I'm not going to mess with it. We've been going long enough. Folks, thanks so much for stopping back to check out the Portable Gamer. Thanks for joining us for episode number 2 of F1 2017 Career Mode. And we'll see you next time. Take care now.